Metro Detroit. Tickets at the Palace Box Office and all Ticketmaster locations. And a big event Thursday, April 2nd, Tampa in the Ice Palace. Tickets to the box office and all Ticketmaster locations. It's WCW on tour all around the world. Coming up next, more great action, including Scott Steiner of the NWO, live on Nitro.
2-1. Scott Hall, the NWO, and this is Buff Bagwell to pitch our new shirt.
Just when you thought, Scotty, we couldn't do any more. Boom!
You're wrong. We're not afraid to come at you with a new shirt.
Get your NWO Rules and Glory t-shirt for only $20. Just call 1-800-NWO-0242.
These are hot.
Rules and bones are made to be broken. Chuh, just rolls off the tongue.
It does.
The preceding announcement has been paid for by the New World
Order. Spring Breakout 1998 continues. During a spring break, colleges, fraternities from all across the country enjoying their Nitro parties wherever you are right now. Of course, many of the colleges on spring break and many colleges here during the course of the break. David Pender ringing out for acknowledging schools. Florida State University has a lot of fans here, a lot of students here. We also have students from Duke. There you see from Iowa, North Carolina. Also from the University of Pittsburgh. From students from Canada. From University of Alabama are here.
Oh, I ran into a bunch of sorority girls today from the Phi Beta Phi. They were just dancing up and down the hall.
Oh, Holly?
University of Alabama. It was quite exciting in the lobby. People are all over the place.
And Duke as well. And, of course, there were some students here from my alma mater at James Madison University in Virginia. Good to see them here as well.
Don't they make donuts?
No, they don't.
That's Dolly.
And Scott Steiner makes his way in at the NWO. You know, you look up and down Scott Steiner, the trademark biceps are the same, but that's about it. I can't believe it. I mean, you have to, when I see him walk into the arena or here at Club La Vila, you just got to stare at him because it
makes you still do. You do a double take.
And you know, another thing, Ray Traylor was very close with the Steiners at one time.
Oh, tag team partners.
And let's think about this. Ray Traylor was a member of the New World Order. Ray Traylor came back to WCW only because that James J. Dillon said a clause in the contract prevented him from going to the NWO. And Ray Traylor, when he came back to WCW, had no friends. It was Scott Steiner along with Rick Steiner that took Ray Traylor in. The only two men that would do that, along with Ted DiBiase. And then for Ray Traylor to have Scott Steiner make that turn that he did to the NWO, that really got Ray right in the gut, guys.
And it's payback time this evening on Nitro for Ray Traylor against his former Trios tag team partner in six-man competition in Scott Steiner.
See, that's the trouble with a lot of these yo-yos. They worry about emotion and friendship. So you never know when something like this is going to happen. Never make friends with anybody. Keep it business.
Get
do your back. Own thing.
Ray, you don't want emotion, to that, baby!
Speaking of emotion and friendship, how about what exists or doesn't exist between Hollywood Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage? Can you believe? I mean, when Eric Bischoff came out here at the beginning of the program and signed that tag team match, he firmly in his heart thought that they were back together again. That is anything but the case, Mike. They are far further apart than ever before, but they will be a tag team tonight.
Well, that surely is an emotional situation between Hogan and Savage. Eric Bischoff put both men's names, signed them both to the contract, obviously without consulting Randy Savage. He thought that he was going to be able to bring them together.
Bond.
Not certainly the case in the mind of Randy Savage from what we heard earlier.
Randy Savage not only is a madman, a wild man, he is a man who is out to prove a point. To prove a point, and that point is that he wants to rule the New World Order. He thinks the way to rule the New World Order, and he's probably right, is to bring the World Championship back around his waist. And let's say if Savage becomes World Champion down the road.
Look what that does to World Championship Wrestling.
I know that, but what does it do to the pecking order of the NWO?
Well, with Savage being World's Heavyweight Champion, he's the number one man in professional wrestling, and you'd have to think that some of the members of the NWO might join with the Macho Man.
Well, you have to look at a lot of different ways. There's a lot of different ways you can go in this. Sting, the fabulous athlete the man is.
Yeah.
I still think Savage is geared to do two things. One, to become champion of the world, and two, to stick it right to Hogan. I think Savage has more going for him right now than anybody in this sport today.
Yeah, but let's not discount the man who is the world heavyweight champion.
That's right.
That is Sting. It's not Savage, although Sting realizes that you really can't side with a member of the NWO at all.
And Savage probably wants to get under Hogan's skin, maybe even more than the World's Heavyweight title, but he knows that by winning that World's Heavyweight Championship, almost a means to an end, that just really raises his profile in the NWO.
Ray Traylor biting his way out of that massive bear hug from the big arms of Scott Steiner. Traylor over the top. Steiner! Oh, boy, almost knocked him out with that one. Cross the eyes of Big Ray Traylor with a forearm shot right between the eyes. Here comes Scotty Steiner, and he kicks him out of the ring. Traylor all the way down to the floor, all the way down to the mats around the apron of the ring here at Club La Villa. We are told we must take another commercial break. As always, the tape machines are rolling. Scott Steiner of the NWO. Ray, oh, my goodness. The head hit the steel steps very hard. With that, we leave you. We'll be back with more live on Nitro.
Have a great
a sheer battle between two men. And Ray Traylor has mounted quite a comeback here. The fans are up as Ray Traylor is pounding on the forehead of Scott Steiner, guys.
What a physical struggle between these two heavyweights. And Ray Traylor has just turned the tide. Advantage Traylor.
He'd rather have him pounding on his forehead.
I think he would too. I would agree with that, Brain. To the ring post they go, and now on the outside, Scott Steiner.
Uh-oh.
Oh my goodness, Scott Steiner! Scott Steiner is in the pool!
We have a winner. Give that man the Cupid doll.
Wow.
I tell you, Scott Steiner slowly pulling himself out as he landed in the pool. But to be very honest with you, that may not be a bad place to land. I'd rather land in the water than maybe crack my head against the side of the pool or something like that, guys.
Yeah, but now look at him sliding around out there. It's going to be tough for him to maintain any kind of traction.
It sure is. It'll be tough for Ray Traylor to hold on to him as well. He posts Scott Steiner to the ring post in the near side. Well, the tradition continues here on Nitro at Club La Villa. During spring breakout, it was Scott Steiner who gets wet in the pool, and Ray Traylor who nails it. Well, you can see the water off the head of Scott Steiner. Ray Traylor, like a man possessed here, guys.
Scott Steiner trying to beg off. Ray Traylor, having none of it, follows up in the corner. Series of big right hands delivered to the side of the head.
Traylor sends Scott Steiner in. The big splash. Steiner wobbly an uppercut. Traylor may have him beat.
Don't walk around. Do it.
Whoa, high risk move from Ray Traylor. Well, something we don't see very often.
No, you're right, Mike. We very rarely see it, but he's on target. Ray Traylor can win the match.
Got him.
One, two, and no. Didn't get him. Oh, my. I thought that was it.
I thought he had him.
Ray Traylor relentless now. Down goes Scott Steiner.
Every time Steiner goes down, he leaves a
wet spot.
Yeah, wet spot. He's taking on more water than the Titanic.
Traylor to go up again. We have Buff Bagwell, who's arrived. Oh! He pulls the foot of Ray Traylor, knocking him off balance, straddling the ropes. Scott Steiner back to his feet. Buff Bagwell, here's this NWO mentality. Help out your fellow man. Help out your partner. I guess it applies to everyone except Hogan and Savage. And off the top of the Frankensteiner. And that means the Steiner recliner, the submission hold, the version of the camel clutch.
And what is Bagwell doing in the ring?
He's got the belt. And Traylor says, yes, that's all.
Finally, just couldn't take it any longer.
Bagwell stopping Ray Traylor. Threatens referee Mickey J. There may be a power struggle at the top of the NWO, but within many of its members, they are still looking out for each other. There's evidence right there, guys.
That is now measuring the bicep.
27 inches. Mm-hmm.
27 inches.
It's a pretty fair arm, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, if you believe what they say.
Take a look at the replay. Here, Ray Traylor in control sends Scott Steiner first into the guardrail and then clotheslines him up and over the guardrail and right into the pool here at Club La Villa. Well, that really got under the skin of Scott Steiner. NWO mate Buff Bagwell out to help. There you see the Frankensteiner off the top rope. And Scott Steiner at that point, that set up his finishing move, the Steiner recliner, yanking back on the neck. The wind almost looked like a chokehold at that point.
Looks like he's choking him out.
Scott Steiner, impressive win over Ray Traylor on Nitro.
The action continues leading up to our third hour main event. You heard us right if you joined us. Hollywood Hogan will team with the Macho Man Randy Savage as they will go up against World Champion Sting and the Total Package Lex Luger live here tonight. Also, three title matches still to come. But before we go any further, earlier in the night, the NWO, they came out with Hollywood Hogan talking about how Kevin Nash proved to the world that he was the real giant in our sport. Let's go back to Uncensored. Just